Hey, guys and girls, welcome back to another episode of Beamng Drive. In today's episode, I've been issued a sort of a challenge. Actually, it's more of an idea, not really a challenge. Little Rascal on the Magnified Forum has suggested I do something interesting. And that is taking vehicles I've created in automation, putting them into environments in Beamng Drive that they don't really belong in. So what we're going to do today is we're going to take the Kono Buzzbox Turbo off-roading. As you can see, this is a 25 horsepower, like 600cc three-cylinder turbo sports car, and we're going to take it off-roading just to see how it goes. Now remember, this vehicle does not have any off-road, you know, off-road potential whatsoever. It doesn't have four-wheel drive or all-wheel drive. It doesn't have low range. It doesn't have any of those things that would assist it going off-road. So what we're going to do is we're going to take this vehicle and we're going to go stick it off-road and see how it goes. So it's sort of taking vehicles that don't belong in that environment and putting them in that environment. So sort of out of place. So that's what we're going to do now. So let's get this party started. We're going to take the Econo Buzzbox Turbo, and then we're going to see how far we can take it off-road. Now, the map I'm using today is called Muddy Place. You can get it through the repository in Beamng Drive. It's called Muddy Place, and it's really an off-road map. It's not really an on-road map at all. It's got some pretty good trails and a lot of mud. So let's get this party started. See how we go here. Ooh, approach and departure angles not the best. Now I'm going to avoid the big rock because I already know that it's going to cause all sorts of problems for us. I'll try and climb over this one, but I think we're going to have troubles. Yeah. As I said, it's not four-wheel drive or all-wheel drive. So, climbing over things, not at strong suit. Should be able to climb over that, surely. Yep, look at that. No problems. Yeah, a 25 horsepower, two-wheel drive, three-cylinder sports car really doesn't belong off-road. Keep going down this trail. We'll see how we go. Whoa! The rocks are getting bigger and harder to avoid. Oh boy, here we go. This is where the fun will begin. Now, I hope, Little Rascal, this is what you actually meant. I think you wanted me to take it onto the Utah map, but I figured this is more of a challenge than the Utah map because there's a lot more obstacles, a lot more mud, and look, there's even water. Let's see how we go. Is this thing going to hydro-lock? I don't know. I killed it. It's hydro-locked. So, yeah. There you go. 25 horsepower, two-wheel drive, doesn't belong off-road. So we'll do a quick reset. We're going to bring in the other Econo Buzzbox, the 15 horsepower version, if I still have it. There it is. Let's bring that in, and we'll see how far we can go off-road with this one. Now, this only has 15 horsepower, so 10 horsepower less than the other one. So I don't know how we're going to go. Gotta be careful here. Oh, we're lifting wheels already. It's going all right. It's not going too bad. Tiny little wheels. I think it's actually bigger than the Econo Buzzbox Turbo, but not longer. Now, I am being a little bit more heavy on the throttle because this has got pretty much a little bit higher ground clearance. But still. Well, that's a big rock. That's another big rock. Gosh, the rocks look so much bigger in this thing. Okay, instead of going through the water this time, let's go through the mud. Made it! Bit of momentum. Momentum is key. Oh, that was a big hit. Okay, round we go. Oop! Not dead yet. It's not even damaged. So she's pretty strong, pretty durable. Yeah, this is not gonna go well. Why don't we back her up? Let's just send it. We already know this is gonna end in tears. So, let's just send it. Yep, we're dead. Knew that was going to end in tears. Alright, let's do a reset. Let's bring in... what other vehicle should we take that doesn't belong off-road? These two... are in an up-and-coming video, so we ignore them right now. We're gonna take the dark side. Yes, those are the two up-and-coming vehicles that'll be done in a video shortly. All right, let's see how we go here. Oh, it's so good to drive something with power. Yeah, ground clearance, not so much. Let's go this way. Nope, not gonna go that way because that's a lake, so we'll go this way. Now, the one thing that this does have on its side is it has a rear diff lock. Dirt donuts! Let's do it! Righto. Now, I gotta figure out how we can get from where we are to where we need to be without killing the dark side. And I'm thinking speed. And for good measure, we'll lock the rear diff in. Let's see how we go. Oh, losing it. That's a tree. Alright, let's do a quick reset. Let's take the dark side down the same trail we went before, and we'll see if we can get across that little thing with a bit of momentum. Now, I apologize for any audio clicking that you might hear. The next door neighbors are using power tools, and every time he turns one on or turns one off, it sends a click through the headset and I can hear it. I don't think his tools are, you know, modern and they don't have electronic shielding. if you hear a drop saw, you'll know it's not me. I can tell you what though, the Econo buzz boxes were easier to get through than this thing. This is a lot bigger, wider. Excuse me. The inhalation burp happening there. Let's go through the mud, not the water. Ooh, I damaged it. Oh well, we'll keep breathing. Oh, big hit. As the others did, but I'm hoping we'll get further into the mud and water than the others. So, Dark Side, I'm going to apologize in advance because I have a feeling we're going to drown this. Oh, I can't even get through. That rock just took out the drivetrain. Let's go. Further, but she dead. It ain't living no more. Oh well. I wonder if I can get through and just by rev dumping it. I gotta be very quick to do this. 3, 2, 1, reset drive, go. 3, 2, 1, reset drive, go. This is why I want snorkels in automation. If I had a snorkel, we'd be getting through this without any problems. Yeah, let's see if I can't drag this thing through, because look at the terrain underneath the river. I'm stuck on a mountain of mud. So let's zoom out if I can. Zoom out, control and hold on to something here and then pull. Nearly there. Let's try again. Hold on to here and pull. No, you're back in the water again. Come on, hold on to here and pull. Right. We're across the river. So let's restart and see if we can keep going. So let's try this again. Restart. Mud fountain. We're through. So V8 muscle cars don't do well in deep water. I'm just saying. Discovered that even with a diff lock, rear-wheel drive, not so good off-road. So the last car I'm going to bring in on this map is going to be the Ugly Duckling. We'll see how the ugly duckling goes off-road. Turn. Okay, reset. Try again. Okay, I think I can get around this first one by going over here. Okay, that got me through there. Oh, you need ride height in this thing. Okay, let's see. Maybe if I back her up. Far back. There is no suspension in this thing. And no grip. Okay, maybe if I can get to... this is so hard. How do I get through? I can see some dirt there, but I'm having a feeling that if I go into it, it's going to be a deep river with a mountain peak in the middle. Let's give it a go. Yep, I killed it. She did. Alright, so what we're going to do now, guys and girls, is we are going to change maps. Going to go here. We're going to go to the play. We go free roam. We're going to go to Italy. Italy. Where are you, Italy? Italy. We're going to go to Italy, and we are going to go right down in the middle of downtown. Right in the center. Why? Because we're going to take the testosterone V1 for a drive right through the middle of town. Why? Because it sounds like a challenge. The testosterone V1 is not designed to go into a small little narrow street situation. It just isn't. It was designed to do burnouts and go off-road. That was pretty much it. It was designed to do burnouts off-road. Or, yeah, have way too much horsepower for an off-road vehicle. Okay, so we're going to wait until the game loads up. This is how long it actually takes in real life, guys and girls. You know, this is just on my system. On some people with an SSD. This is just the way it is. The more processing power you have, the quicker the game loads. And my system isn't shabby in any way, shape, or form. It's just, it's like 3 years old now and it's starting to show its age. Yeah, that's right. 3 years old, I can't believe it. Alright. Okay, wait for everything to buffer in. Come on. There we go. Not quite ready yet. There we go. Now we're ready to go. Alright, so let's get in the testosterone V1. Where is it? There it is. Boogie Off-Road. Testosterone V1. And we're going to see if we can drive it through the narrow streets of Italy. Come on. There we go. Look at it. This thing is huge. Those streets are not that wide. Gosh, this thing is nearly as tall as first story building apartments. Stop. Oh boy, this is not easy. In fact, to make life a little bit easier on myself, I'm turning the four-wheel drive system off. That was a mistake. going to make that turn? No. That is really awkward. Drift's alright. Look at the view. Beautiful countryside. Overpowered 4x4. Really doesn't belong in the narrow city streets of Italy. Can I actually fit down here? Oh boy. Oh, nope, there goes the front bumper. I can't even fit to turn around in there. Where the Econo Buzzbox Turbo feels right at home. High-powered 4x4 really isn't suited to twisty Italian backroads. Alrighty, guys and girls, thank you so much for watching this episode. Don't forget to like, comment, subscribe, share, and don't forget hit that little ding-a-ling alarm button so you can stay up to date with everything I do on BeamNG and radio control in general. Don't forget, I have a huge playlist now of automation activities, so I will put an end card on the end of this video that you can go and watch all the fun and mayhem that I have done in automation / BeamNG. And don't forget, the next episode is going to be an exciting one because I have built two vehicles for someone very important to me. So I built two vehicles for that person. One built to sort of their specifications and the other one just built for the hell of it. So stay tuned for that one. That will be coming up shortly. Until next time, I will say bye for now. See ya!